Having hosted hundreds of webinars in the past 5 years, I've witnessed firsthand the power of webinars when it comes to virtually connecting with people all over the world. And I'm not alone. Tons of brands are using webinars to reach their best prospects at all corners of the web. But hosting a successful webinar isn't always easy. It requires strategic planning, the right eye-catching topic, and a knock-your-socks-off presentation. And to achieve success, one of the most important details to nail down is when you're going to host your webinar. Is there an ideal date and time to host a webinar? How do you maximize attendance even with viewers all over the world? I've researched and analyzed data from thousands of webinars with millions of attendees to finally answer the question, when is the best time to host a webinar? The key to hosting a successful webinar is proper planning. That means not leaving the timing or execution of your webinar up to chance. Based on recent data, we know for certain that the timing of your webinar does matter when it comes to maximizing attendance. If you're going to invest the energy and money into running a webinar, you want to attract as many attendees as possible. More attendees equals better results and more conversions. Since people's schedules vary, some days are better webinar days than others. In identifying the best day for a webinar for your audience, you'll want to select a day and time that works for the greatest number of attendees. In fact, there are many ways to increase viewership and maximize conversions on your webinars. And more attendees equals better results. Now, without further ado, let's see what the data has to say in terms of the best days to host your webinars. On the webinar platform ON24 compiled data from thousands of webinars to create their 2024 benchmark report on digital marketing and webinars. This report provides valuable insights into webinar performance, the best days for hosting, and more. While this report analyzed data related to all levels of webinar creation and promotion, for the purpose of this video, we're looking specifically at data that reflects the best days and times for hosting. Our goal here is to give you the tips you need to connect with more prospects using successful online presentations. So what are the best days for a webinar? The ON24 study found Wednesday and Thursday to be the best days to host a webinar. This is consistent with previous data from other reports across other years. The data goes as follows: Mondays, 9%, Tuesday, 25%, Wednesdays, slightly higher, 26%, Thursday, 28%, Friday, 9%, Saturday and Sunday, 4%. Essentially, midweek is the best time to hold a webinar, with Monday typically being a catch-up day to start the week and Friday being a day where people have their minds towards the weekend already. The weekend, Saturday and Sunday, attracted the lowest number of attendees on average. The caveat, there's no one day that fits all audiences. It's recommended that you test timing with your audience to see which days yield the highest results. And you can see here that 91% of B2B professionals say webinars are their preferred type of content. 83% of webinars have fewer than 50 live attendees. So don't be concerned if you're not getting a lot of attendees. 63% of webinar views are on demand, replay. 56% total conversion of webinar registrations to attendee. And webinars with less than 100 registrants have 10.3% higher live attendance rates. An interesting statistic. So, as I said, essentially midweek is the best time to hold a webinar, with Monday typically being your catch-up day. So I would suggest trying Wednesdays and Thursdays and just seeing how it fits your target market audience. While live webinars offer an excellent opportunity to interact with attendees in real time, not all choose to attend live. In 2023, 44% of the total watch on demand or after the live date. This continues to be a trend observed from previous years as on-demand now commands a sizable portion of a webinar's audience, one that cannot be ignored from an overall experience design standpoint and for sales follow-up. Furthermore, 3% of attendees view the same webinar both at the time of broadcast and then re-watch the session later on demand. This group should be a key target for any business owner who is looking to identify those with the highest levels of engagement, as this is likely to be a strong signal of buying intent. Additionally, engagement in on-demand webinars rose 13% over 1 year, and this continues year over year. This outpaces growth in engagement for live events. The importance of offering webinars and other content as on-demand resources is further highlighted by how audiences interact with curated and personalized content. Here, on-demand webinars see more engagement than any other resource. For this reason, business owners must offer anytime access to these experiences so that audiences can continuously interact with them. Business owners need to shift from a one-and-done mindset toward an ongoing engagement strategy. Audience engagement with webinar experiences remains strong. On average, attendees spend 53 minutes viewing and engaging with live webinars, providing a substantial window of time for event organizers and business owners to collect signals and data to further enhance their interactions. Based on the 2024 data, the average viewing time for live webinars was 53 minutes. Note that the ideal webinar length depends heavily on the topic, the audience, and the content in the webinar. Most webinars last about an hour, but can run much longer or shorter depending on the complexity of the topic. The study also found a downward trend in webinar length, perhaps due to the fact that more viewers are watching webinars on the go from their mobile devices. A large number of attendees now watch webinars from their smartphone, and this continues to rise year after year. Overall, your webinar presentation should be long enough to effectively cover the topic, but not so long that you lose your viewers' attention. Keep in mind that this should include a Q&A session, so the actual presentation should often be under 45 minutes long. This allows time for Q&A, which you should run as long as the attendees are asking questions. Many of your sales or call bookings will happen during the Q&A, so don't cut it short just because you're over the 1 hour mark. The study found 11 a.m. and 2 p.m. to be the time that drew in the highest attendance, but this average is an average and not a rule. In hosting your webinar, you should aim for a time that works for the greatest number of people across time zones. Obviously, this will depend on where your audience lives and what their schedules look like. 56% of people sign up for a webinar at least 8 days in advance, before the actual event. This reaffirms the idea that you should plan your webinar out in advance rather than wait until the last minute. About 25% of companies start promoting their webinars at least 2 weeks before the event. I recommend at least a week in advance, with the majority of your email promotion coming within the final 3 days to increase your show-up rate. Encouraging engagement throughout the webinar is essential, especially if you want attendees to be itching to opt into your offer. One study from Experiences Everywhere showed that top-performing webinars incorporated additional materials and multimedia elements to boost engagement and personalize their content. The top tools to boost engagement were PowerPoint slides, 91%, Q&As, 81%, polls, 78%, surveys, 73%. As a result of using these tools, 81% of webinar hosts said that their audiences were engaged with the webinar content. High audience engagement is correlated with higher conversion rates and end sales. Increasing engagement on your webinars could even double your revenue numbers. You don't have to rely on a live-only webinar to drive sales. You can host a live version and an on-demand version to attract as many viewers as possible. Then you can integrate this on-demand webinar into an evergreen content, attracting new users for weeks and even months to come. While the above data provides a ton of insight into webinar success, you should always plan out your webinar based on the unique interests, goals, and schedules of your audience. This means testing the timing of your webinar, the content, the engagement tools you use, and your offer. Webinars can be powerful tools in driving leads to your business. With 38% of survey respondents considering webinar leads to be above average, you can't afford to sleep on the money-making content marketing tool webinars provide. The key is to establish a rock-solid funnel with the perfect offer to entice your audience. So, just to recap, by now we have covered the top days and times for hosting a webinar, as well as some bonus tips for maximizing attendance. While the data does reveal some powerful insights into how to boost a successful webinar and how to host this, the success of your webinar will be greatly dependent on you establishing your own unique data-driven strategy.